For this project, we're going to make baling twine dolls. This is one of them. And this is the other. So for each of these doll projects, I used 12 short pieces of twine. These are just scrap pieces of twine that were, I had nothing else to do with, so I just made dolls. They're too short to do a lot of the projects. These strands have kind of a crimp in them because they were previously braided, and I unbraided them because they were just scraps. So I unbraided them for this project. 12 strands, short strands, just miscellaneous pieces, which is why there's a variety of colors in the project. These arms, I just tied knots in and cut them off. These, I tied a knot in and wove them back through, or brought them back through to be integrated into the rest of the project. All right. Thank you. Have fun. These doll projects will be using just scrap pieces of twine, so they're short lengths. These pieces, I have 12 pieces of from strands here, and these pieces have a crimp in them because they've previously been braided, so it leaves a crimp. For this one, I want the top pieces to kind of fall down, so I'm going to tie a knot about right here so that all these top pieces will fall down. The knot doesn't have to be too tight, because this is going to be the head, so just leave it like that. Then, so for 12 strands, and if we want three, each braid is going to have 4 pieces of twine. So I'm just going to braid a few rows below the knot. Now I'm going to take 3 strands out off each side. And keep these middle ones together. So then I will braid a few inches from out. And then I'm just going to tie a knot at the end of this for the hand. We'll come back and trim that later. you can tie in a knot at the end for the hand. Now we have 6 strands in the center, and we'll just divvy those up to braid a few more rows. So here, I'm going to add 3 new pieces. These are just short scrap pieces of a different color. I'm going to add them all together, 3 short pieces, and just braid them in. Keep them with this one for a couple of twists. To get it braided in. Now I'm just going to go back to the orange. Just a couple more rows. And now I'm going to divide these into 2 different braids for legs. Tie a knot at the end. Making sure to get all your strands through. Same for this side. Another knot at the end. we'll just trim up the strands. Give the knot another tight pull before you trim it up. Here is this doll. For this doll, again, I have 12 short strands of twine, just scrap pieces. I am going to tie my knot towards the top for this one. Divide it into a 3-strand braid, so each will have 4 short pieces. Now I'm going to divide it for arms. So we need 3 here. Tie a knot here again. But this time, actually, I'll do the other arm first and then we'll come back to this. tie my knot. Tighten it up. And now I'm gonna braid back to the body part of the doll, to the torso. And I'm going to clamp it so it doesn't come undone while I do the other side. I'm just going to fold these back over and bring these strands back into the main braid. Leaving the arms looped out and pulling everything tight. So here I'm going to divide everything in half for legs. So there's four. And just a tight knot at the end with a foot. And make sure you get all your strands through. And just sort your strands however it works to get everybody, all of them in there tightly. Another tight knot at the end, making sure to get all your strands through. Give each strand its own pull. Okay. When you're comfortable that it's tight, as tight as you want it, and we'll trim up the ends. Same for this one, make sure it's as tight as you want it. Turn up the ends. There's that doll.